Hey everyone, welcome to PhotoshopProHelp. Now today I'm going to be teaching you this awesome effect. It's called the fireworks text effect. Now this effect goes amazingly well with most images and it is really easy and simple to create. Now first things first is we're going to be needing our font to be working with. Now the font I went for is called Second Lyrics. Now you can find a free font that is a paid for font from thefonts.com, and there is a free version of that font somewhere on the internet. You can just search it on Google by typing in Second Lyrics font, but if I do find the free version, the link is going to be in the description bar for you to go and download. Now if you can't find it and you don't want to pay for it, now you just want to look for any font that has a handwritten style to it that goes really well with fireworks effect. Now once you have downloaded and installed your font into your font folder on your computer, we're just going to go and load our image into Photoshop that we're going to be working with. Now this here is a panorama of a bridge in Germany, a really nice one. So all we're going to do from here is we're just going to go to our text tool on the left hand side, click our picture, and we're just going to go up to the top, change the size of our font. It's going to be set to 175, and we're just going to go to the drop down menu at the top again and select our font that we just installed. So there's mine, Second Lyrics, 175, and we're just going to go and type any message that we want. So I'm just going to go and type in 2013 and place that a bit better to over here. Now from here all we're going to do is go to our characters menu. Now that should be on the right hand side. If you can't find it, it's really easy and simple to go and find. Just go up to window at the top and go to character. Now once you have done that and you get this little menu pop up, we're just going to go and change the VA to 100. So set that to 100. That does the spacing in between the letters and numbers. So change that. And from here we're just going to go right click our text layer and go to create work path, and we're just going to go and hide that now, hide that layer. And now if I zoom in, as you can see, it's created a outline of our font, our text, and all we're going to do from here is create a new blank layer, bottom right hand side, and we're just going to go and click our paintbrush tool. You want to make sure that you've got white as your foreground color. That should be set to default. And we're just going to go up, select our brush. Now it's going to be called Dune Grass. You want the one bladed grass, not the three. That should be 112. We're just going to go and set the size to 40 pixels. Now I will say what you have written, so I've typed in 2013. Now these settings are going to be going with the 2013 text. Now if you was to type hello or welcome or whatever you're going to type in this specific font, you will have to change the sizes and some of the details to make this look right. So I will say if you're going to write a long message into it, I would say do the individual words separately, so you can just muck around with all the details and get it just perfect. So I'm going to go for 40 because this works for this version, or maybe just a tad little bit smaller, say about 30 in size. And then we're just going to go up to our brush menu, which is on the right hand side. As I said, if you can't find it, go up to window and select brush. So click there, sorry, our brush menu. And we're just going to go and make sure that size is 40 or whatever we have selected. Spacing is going to be set to 25. Shape dynamics is going to be size jitter 100%. Minimum diameter is going to be set to 1 or 0%. Angle jitter 100%. Roundness jitter 100%. And minimum roundness is going to be set to 0 or 1%. Going to go up to, all the way up to the top to control. Click pen pressure and go to scattering. From here we're just going to go and change the scattering to 100%, and we're just going to go and uncheck color dynamics. From here all we're going to do is hide that and go to our pen tool on the left hand side, right click our text, our outline, and go to stroke path. Make sure you got brush selected in tools, and make sure you got simulate pressure clicked on, and click OK. Now once you have done that, we're going to go up back to our brush, and our brush menu, and go and click enter again. As we already have done the pen bit, we can just click enter and it should automatically do it again. Now I've clicked enter once and it hasn't done it. It might need two clicks. There we go, it's repeated it for us. Now all we're going to do is change the scattering. So we're going to go and change it to 300, and we're just going to go and click enter. One enter might not work. Click it again, and as you see, it's applied the effect. Now we're just going to go and hide that. We're going to go and double click our new layer, which should be layer 1, and we're going to go to outer glow, and we're going to go and change the blending mode to a linear dodge. We're going to put the opacity to 50%, and we're going to go and change the color. Now the color, you really can have any color that you want. We're going to go for a light red for this one. So this is going to be set to FF6D6D, and all we're going to do is change the size. Click OK for that. Change the size to 250, and you want the range to be about 50% on that one, so we get a nice evenness to it. Now from here, all we're going to do is click OK, and we're going to go and make a new blank layer, so bottom right hand side, and we're just going to go back up to our brush tool on the left hand side, go up to the top and change our brush. We're going to go for the star is next to the blade grass brush that we just selected, so click that. That should be around about 70. We're going to keep with 70 for this specific 2013, but as I said, change the size depending on whatever size font you've selected or if you've written anything else. So we're going to go and keep that. Go back to our brush menu on the right hand side, and we're just going to go change some of these. Go to make the spacing 50%, and we're going to go to shape dynamics. Now this should be already set for you, just exactly the same as we did last time. So size jit 100%, minimum diameter 0 or 1, angle jit 100%, roundness jit 100%, and minimum roundness 1% or 0%, and make sure you got pen pressure clicked on. Now once you have done that, we're going to go to scattering, and we're just going to go and change the scattering to 100%, and the count is going to be set to 4, and the count is going to be set to 98. They should be set to default anyway, and all we're going to do is press enter about 4 times. So we want to apply that effect 4 times. Remember, as I said, sometimes when you click enter it might not work, so there we go, 1, 2, 3, 4. That's 4 times we've applied that, and all we're going to do is change the scattering again to 218, and we're just going to go and click again, apply that effect only once for this, and we're going to change the scattering again to 322, and only apply this once. There we go. And then we're one more, is we're going to change the scattering to 460, and just apply this effect once. There we go. And we're just going to go and hide that. Click the layer 2 that we have just created. There we go. And you're going to change the layer styles. So go to outer glow again. Blending mode is going to be set to linear dodge. We want the opacity to be around about 75. And we're going to go and change the size to 20. So there we go. I'm going to go and change the color. You can have the color anything that you want. It doesn't have to be the same as mine. I'm going to set this to a lovely bright orange, so FF6C00, and then I'm just going to go click OK, and you want the range to be 50% again, and then click OK, and then click delete, and that should delete the outline that we don't need anymore. Now once you have done that, as you can see, this is the effect that we're after, and it looks amazing. Now play around with this effect, change all the settings depending on what you're writing, Now I would say, if you have done it small, or if it is too small of writing for your picture, really isn't simple to do. It just go and select the two layers that we have created by holding down Control and clicking both, and then press Control and T to free transform. You get this lovely box around it. Hold down Shift on your keyboard and then drag outwards or drag inwards depending on whatever size that you want, and then click the tick icon at the top, and there you have it. It renders back to where it should be and to the right size that you specifically asked for. Now that was really easy, simple to do. Go and try it for yourself. I will go and look for the text and the font now for you to go and get. And please comment, rate and subscribe, and I'll see you next time, guys. Bye for now.